Hello, welcome to FX Bootcamp. My name is Jarius Jenkins and this is your Tokyo session video briefing. What follows is the live wrap-up of the major item or items we covered during the session at fxbootcamp.com.
Today we had trade balance coming out of Australia. This was going to provide us with potential for a decent opportunity to trade. We always begin trading by looking for areas of support and resistance and trying to find a break of those levels of support and resistance. So what we do is we begin by zooming out of our charts and looking for obvious levels of support and resistance. Now, ideally, we'll see the news price give us, the news move give us enough momentum to break right through those levels of support and resistance onto making new levels. What happened with our news? Well, when the news came out, price spiked up about 20 pips or so and immediately came back down. We drew in our levels of support and resistance as defined by the news, and we're looking for a break of either support or resistance. The next candle immediately saw price break through the low of this candle and may have potentially put us in on a short. As we watched price action unfold, we saw that price continued down. We had a 5-8 cross pointing to the downside. This is on a 5-minute chart. We also had the 21 and 55 head to the downside, which confirmed our short off of the break of this level of support. And we watched this price continue down. It made it to a low of 82.16, so it came down from 82.27 to 82.16. At this point in time, many of our members moved their stops to break even, locking in or protecting themselves from any sort of loss due to possible reversal, and allowing them to sit and watch as the price rode down further if it did. We soon saw that price spiked up again, and we were very close to 5-8 cross. We saw a 5-8 cross, which would have had many of our people following this method possibly get out of the move, as we saw that price was not following through as we would like to see it follow through. And this gave us an exit of about 82.23. On an entry of 82.27, you're either getting out at break even or with a 1 or 2 pip loss. As we continued on, we saw that price pulled up further and for the rest of the day. Price continued up and up and up. Now, when we take a look at price action on the 15-minute chart, we get something of a story that is told to us. First, if we take a zoom out to take a look at the bigger picture, we see that the 21.55 are pointing up, so our speed is up and our trend is up. When the news comes out, it spikes up and immediately spikes down to the 55. Now, if you watch price action, you often see that price in an uptrend will first test the 21, and if it can get through the 21 as it does here, it'll test the 55, and the 55 will often provide support. If price is interacting more with the 55 than the 21, then you'll often see that price breaks to the 55 to test the 200. But in this case, we had the 21 as the major support, and price was simply testing the 55. After a test of the 55, price bounced up strongly to, again later in the day, test the 55 again and bounce up strongly to, again later in the day, test the 21 and the 55 and the 55 to test the 55 and 55 again and again. what we get from this look is that even though we have a method that has a set idea of how we trade news, it is not necessarily the best in our best interest to trade that method blindly. We need to take into consideration the current market conditions, what price is doing, what price action dictates, and use our common sense and our understanding of market action to decide when we want to trade against the trend, when we want to trade a news trade as a set method versus when we want to make use of all the information the market has to tell us before taking a trade. This is something that hopefully we'll be able to go over again and again, and all of our members will be able to continue to learn at fxbootcamp.com.